हेलो फ्रेंड्स, सिस्टर्स, ब्रदर्स, प्रोफेसर्स, लेक्चरर्स एज वेल एज रिलेटिव्स, सत श्री अकाल, नमस्कार, नमस्कार। एज पार्ट ऑफ दिस माइक्रोस्कोपी इज द आर्ट ऑफ नॉलेज, फोल्डोस्कोप एट होम। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शो द आंसर्स ऑफ कंटेस्ट सीरीज ऑफ माइक्रोस्कोपी पार्ट 8, विच इज स्वेट सैंपल। माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर प्रवीण कुमार, PhD in Optical Coatings, CSIR CSIO, Chandigarh. So, coming to the answers of this sweat sample, we will see some kind of requirements to which this sample can be seen under foldoscopy. So, the requirements are paper slides, magnifier, tape, tweezer as well as scissors. So all these components are important to understand the microscopy of sweat sample and it will be used. So once after collection of these components, we will see how this magnifier will be used to see the magnification of this sweat sample, and after that we can collect the images. This is the sweat sample which is in the liquid form. You can see clearly the liquid drop you can see on the paper slide which was collected. In a similar manner, I have zoomed the same image in a higher magnification side and have taken the same image. So once after this drop of sweat was dried off on the same sample, it looks in such a manner. You can see the clearly small crystals are there. These crystals can be viewed in microscopy and we can frame and we can see the knowledge of these things, how these crystals are been looked in which shape. This is the microscopic image of sweat sample. It shows that clearly the NaCl crystals which are salt can be visualized under the microscopy. This is the one of the salt crystal. Four salt crystals can be seen in this particular image. There are many number of crystals are there in this particular image. So by this we can understand sweat consists of salt material which is of NaCl. So clearly students, we can understand that sweat sample consists of salty particles, that particles having a structure of NaCl molecules which is having tetragonal structure. So this is also one of the few more images which I have collected from the same microscopy and it looks in such a manner. So this is the video which I have captured under this microscopic of foldoscope technique which was shown in this particular slide. And see the clearly how this sweat sample image was seeing and how it is viewing under microscopy. So this is one of the crystals which it is been there in the liquid after a liquid sample after dried it, and we can see under the foldoscope image. Then we can understand what kind of crystals are there, what is this and what is the orientation, how these things are been understand can be microscopic image. Here is the sweat sample which is seen clearly. This image only have taken and have asked the question through the contest of microscopy. So few more crystals we can see clearly from this sweat sample. There are few more crystals are visualizing clearly. You can see here there are more number of crystals. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 crystals we can see in a salt NaCl compounds. NaCl crystals can be seen clearly on a sweat material. Here one more crystal we can see clearly. So once after completion of this kind of experiment, I thought to do another experiment, which was of the dust accumulated on the human body after sweating. That material I have taken and I have seen under the microscope, and what is the difference between the liquid sweat sample, dried it, and after accumulation of dust was collected and seen in the microscopy, can be analyzed through this microscopic study. For this also I have taken magnification lens, and this is the paper slide which consists of liquid sample sweat one, and another sample which was dust collected from the human body after the sweating. This is the dust collected from this sweat was taken in this macroscopic image. So these both samples was monitored in the microscopic lenses which was collected and purchased from fluoroscope instruments. So this is the sweat sample image under microscopic art without using any polarization filters. Once after understanding this polarization filter without polarization filter, I have used polarization filter to understand the difference and how the light phenomena was changing. Basically, polarization filter is a filter which allows for some portion of light in which is parallel to the each other and some portion of light which is perpendicular to each other. That is magnetic field and electric field kind of things will be allowed. So that thing we can see in this particular thing. Once if I am using the orientation of polarization filter in one orientation, this is showing in such a manner. That thing is also in a similar way. Other kind of things I have captured in the same dust accumulated on human body after sweating. So here you can see clearly the defective portions of the NaCl crystals can be visualized. In a similar manner, polarization filter utilization on this dust accumulated of human body have captured, and these are the two images which we can see clearly. So here we can understand that the dust accumulated on the surface of the body will have defective in salt NaCl crystals can be understood. So this is the microscopic view of human sweat sample accumulated dust under the fluoroscope instrument. You can see clearly the crystals are in a defective portion and how it is varied in a very very distorted manner. Okay friends, thanks a lot for watching this video. Please share to all your friends and understand that sweat sample consists of salt crystals which is of NaCl having tetragonal structures. Thanking you friends for watching this video. Thanks a lot.